another tool to add to your inventory. My name is Akshita and I'm an international med student studying the Bachelor of Medical Studies and Doctor of Medicine at UNSW Sydney. Today we are going to be discussing something a little bit different but a little bit closer to home, and that is how you live and how you struggle as an international student. Today I'm going through some of the things that I feel like I struggle most with as an international student, that things that make me feel less confident, less put together, and what things I am trying to do to get through that as we get better at being international students. So let's get into it. So the very first thing, let's cut to the chase and get to the main thing that everybody worries about: finances. I have had this channel for about 6 months now, and in those 6 months, whoever has ever messaged me on Instagram or written up to my comments on YouTube, the biggest question is always, what's the fee going to be like? Do we have scholarships to help us out with the fees? Because there's no denying it. As an international student, the biggest hurdle is the fact that you are an upfront full fee paying student. That's where not feeling guilty is a huge struggle. What I've learned, and from what my mom and dad and my sister keep telling me, that's an unhealthy way to think about it. From my culture, and from most cultures that I'm pretty sure are watching this video, the sense of family being a team, helping you realize your dreams, is very strong. And that's how my mom, my sister, and my dad think about it. It's not my decision to come and study medicine in Australia. It's not like I wanted it, so they're doing it. It's more like we as a family decided that we are going to chase our ambitions, and we think that you can do this there, and that's why all of us as a team are going to make sure that you study medicine, or all of us are together going to make sure that my sister does her PhD. A more healthier way to think about the fact that your finances is a huge part of, you know, a struggle as an international student, is to make sure that you do your part as the team member. If there are tests that come forward, be the high achiever. Push for better and better and better. Keep improving, show improvement in your marks. No matter how many times everyone says, oh, marks don't matter. Excel in whatever you can excel when you know your talents lie there. That's your way of making sure that all the effort that's being put into you in terms of, you know, your mom and dad financing you or your siblings helping you out, all of that, make it count. Make it count by making sure that all the effort that they are putting into giving you opportunities, those opportunities are being used well. And then there are a lot of practical things you can do as well to make sure that you make the most out of the situation. My sister used to often have, I remember when she was younger, like around my age, she used to have this diary where she used to write down monthly expenses every single time and keep track of every single dollar. Where is it going? I use Excel spreadsheets to make sure I have all the fees for each year, when they need to be paid, what installments, and how would it be best for my dad to transfer. We have alerts set up to look at exchange rates. So whenever the exchange rate between my home currency and Australian dollars is at its best is when dad should think about transferring stuff, because it makes sure that you save up a few hundred to even a few thousand dollars just by the exchange rates. So we monitor that almost on a daily basis.
Feeling homesick. I think it's no secret on this channel, I feel homesick quite a lot. 3 years in and I still feel it that way.
This isn't something that's confined to international med students. This is every international student's struggle. You come here for a purpose, so you don't really have that time to settle down and come to terms with the fact that you're going to have to stay a lot more independent from now on, and that protected atmosphere where you could rely on your parents for everything is kind of over. Not just in terms of choice independence, but also in terms of distance. You physically can't be with your parents and friends and family all the time. Not only do you have to do that, you don't have time to get that idea into your head. You are also put into the situation where you now need to learn something new, learn how to fit into university, make new friends at university, and worry about your marks throughout the whole process in the same time. And as international students, we are very academically driven. That it's those marks that got us here. So I feel like it is very hard to come to terms with the fact that sometimes it's not going to work the same way in uni. all of these things are going to crash down on you at some point. But there are a lot of things I feel like in the 21st century make it so much more easier than what it was a few years ago. You have Zoom, you have FaceTime. Sit, keep them on the side of your room, let that stay on, and you will almost feel like the background music of your own house playing there. Every day I spend at least 1.5 to 2 hours where I speak to my sister, mom, and my dad. And that's a staple. It has to happen every day. But when things get really hard, I think it needs to be said that we should get better at asking for help, asking for external help. Universities here have this huge resource in the form of mental health advisors, student advisors, international student advisors, cultural mentors. There's just so much help available, but all you have to do is ask. So it does need to be said that when you are struggling with emotional isolation or being away from family, it is something that we all need to learn how to do, and that is go forward, mingle with these particular groups, ask for help from the student advisors, talk about your struggles, because it's only then will you be able to come to terms with the fact that, hey, this might not be the easiest situation to be in, but there are lots of things that you can take away as a benefit from there. Culture shocks. I finished an assignment that I was really getting irritated with. I just didn't want to have it with me. I just wanted it done. I did finish it. I got up super early. I didn't have to be at the hospital until like 8:30, but I was up at 5:30 and like completely awake. So I decided that I was going to go down to the coffee shops, get my coffee, you guys know this by now, and I just, you know, walk to a park and sit and have coffee there. Now, I had already dressed up in my office, like hospital clothes, because I had to go to hospital immediately after that. And so at like around 6:45 in the morning, I am completely fully official dressed, and I went to the coffee shop, got my coffee, went to the park, and I tried to look for a place to sit down. And as I sat and watched, literally everywhere you had people who were jogging, people who were walking around, walking their dog, people who decided to play tennis in the morning, there were people who brought their skateboards, and at 6 o'clock in the morning, this park is packed, but it's packed with people working out. It's so natural for me to wake up early and think, wow, I'm going to have such an early start to my day. I'm going to have 3 more extra hours to do my work, and I'm going to be like completely done with my to-do list for today earlier because I've gotten up earlier. That culture difference is definitely there. Now, disclaimer, it's not a hard and fast rule. That's probably just me being an extreme case. But these kind of subtle cultural differences will keep popping up. It will be different for every one of us. For me, it's about lifestyles and priorities. For others, it might be how they choose to spend their money. Or for another student, it might be language. For another student, it might be the kind of food. It's a different experience for every international student, but that experience is there. It's really not that much of a deal, but it's something that would jar you when you first enter the country, or any country for that matter, and you should know that that's normal. That is going to happen. There is no way around it except trialing and just taking in the info as it comes. Blending advice from different cultures. Oh, this is a hard one. This is something that I still struggle with so much. I come from a competitive culture. I come from a culture where things are very head-to-head against each other. It's always that mindset of what I'm going to do to make myself stand out from the crowd. What am I going to do to make sure that I am at the top? I have to be the best of the best. That's the mindset that I've come from. And you know what? That's not exactly wrong or evil. Like, these experiences don't come out of nowhere. I was a part of a speech club where the group of students in that club did not talk to me until they heard my first speech, realized that I'm really good at speaking, and then suddenly everybody wanted to sit next to me. There was once when I'd asked my friend, hey, you know what? I really can't understand this question. Do you know how to solve this? She flat out said, no, I don't. And then the question comes in the exam and she said, oh, I actually did know. To my face! The only way you could protect yourself and make sure that you are able to get all the opportunities that you need is to be secretive, hold cards close to your chest, essentially choosing not to help.
voluntarily making that choice. And then I come here. When I walk into the hospital and if I've met a fifth or a sixth year, they volunteer and tell me, look, if you and your classmates need a little bit of help with these things, we can organize some tutes and teach you guys. I started blending the advice. I started learning how to be more open. I started learning how to talk about the things that have helped me get through. This whole YouTube channel is dedicated to explaining the things that I do that help me be more productive and help me get through med school. There have been times when I'm doing this thing and there is something in my heart that says, you are pushing it too far. So over the years, over the 3 years, I've just tried to maintain an open mindset to these things. So trying to get away from that extreme competitive culture, but at the same time, not completely losing out on what my upbringing and my experiences have taught me. I feel like having an open mindset and being willing to try what the newer culture teaches you is probably worthwhile. All right, that's it. Those are the four things that I think most international students struggle with. If you found this video useful and like the information that I've put out in here, make sure to like this video, share it around, and comment down below and tell me what else you struggle with or what are some of the struggles that I might have missed and you would want to hear me talk about it more. If you found any value from this channel in general and want to see more of this stuff coming your way, subscribe to it, make this inventory your own. But until next Friday,